swearing in ceremony of the newly elected members of the Delhi Legislative Assembly. And Amrita, isn't this actually amazing? These ministers, the chief minister who was sworn in first, just look at them. They came out of nowhere and won the confidence of the people of Delhi. They won the hearts of the people to reach where they have. And it's the job of the Congress and the BJP to support them if the endeavor is actually good, Amrita.
No, that's why we are supporting the manifesto, because we were expecting that they are going to reduce the bill of power and they are going to reduce it by 50%. But just merely giving extension of the subsidy is not a solution. They have not delivered on to their promise. They should in entirety should reduce the bill to 50%. There is no reduction of the rates. It's only an extension of subsidy. And there is no clarity, and it's so much of ambiguity on terms of what is going to happen to the people having more than 400 units of usage.
Yes.
So there is, nothing is clear. They have to clarify so many things. And let me tell you, people were not expecting this.
But will you as a constructive opposition, Amrita, or perhaps as somebody who's extending support to the Aam Aadmi Party in the government, will you pose these tough questions to them, or will you support them in their endeavor?
We want to support them, and we want to support them in one endeavor, and that is to reduce the bill for which they have promised. That is how they have fooled the public in Delhi. Now they have to fulfill the promise. They cannot just do it what the Congress government was already doing. Okay. When you have to do only this, then why were you blaming Congress government?
Respond to this, Raghav. You've only increased the subsidy that the Congress was already providing.
Please understand, this is not the only step that we have taken on this. We have issued 3 show cause notices to all the 3 bijli companies of Delhi. We have met with the CAG and he has agreed that he will perform an independent audit of all these companies. So there are a lot of steps in the pipeline. Please wait and watch. This is just one of these steps. Number two, talking about subsidy. Bijli and Pani are the most important issues of Delhi. At least we in our manifesto don't promise that we'll make a double-decker flyovers, double flyovers. I mean, I can stay 15 minutes extra in my in traffic if everyone in Delhi gets water. So, okay, you know, let's be very practical. These are steps and it is a 5-year term. We have promised that we'll reduce the electricity rates, the electricity expenditure in 4 months.
The 5-year term remains the question, but there are facts that Sambit claims we should counter you. Sambit,
Amrita, just a second. Amrita,
have you reduced the bill?
Oh God.
Okay. Have you reduced the rate? Just say yes or no. Or you have extended me a subsidy?
Let's come up with some.
Quickly before I take a break.
First and foremost, the subsidy is not of 200. Please go by the expert's book, and the subsidy totals to somewhere around 1400 crores per year. Secondly and most importantly, why subsidize the company who are corrupt? Kejriwal himself has been saying that these companies are corrupt. BJP has been saying these companies are corrupt.
Now,
everyone knows that they are corrupt. Please, Amrita, hold your thoughts. In spite of the fact that they are corrupt, why the money from the taxpayers' pocket is being paid to these companies? 200 crore worth subsidy means it goes to the pocket of these companies. These companies agree that they have not been able to pay to the Trustco and other government-owned companies. That means they will use our money now to pay back to the government. So it is a systemic way in which our taxpayers' money has been given to the companies whom we say are corrupt.